Hello everyone, and welcome to part 3 of my miniseries analyzing Avatar: The Way of Water. If you haven't seen the first two parts and would like to watch those videos first, the link to those videos will be in the description. But anyways, let's jump right back into it. So we've talked about the visuals, the story, the characters, the themes, but the one big thing that we haven't talked about yet, which is essential for any movie to achieve an all-time classic status, is the musical score. But before I talk about the Way of Water score, I want to give a little bit of context and talk about Avatar 2009's score. So the score for Avatar was written and composed by James Horner, who happens to be my favorite film composer. He is most well known for his iconic scores in Titanic and Braveheart, but also delivered incredible work in films such as Troy, A Beautiful Mind, Legends of the Fall, the list goes on. But Avatar is one of his works you don't really hear talked about that much. So was it any good? Well, in my opinion, Avatar's score is one of the most underrated masterpieces in modern cinema. This score is absolutely astounding. Actually, it might be my favorite of all of James Horner's work throughout his life. Every single piece for this film is absolutely gorgeous. And not only is the music gorgeous on its own, but the most important part about it is that it fits this movie specifically so well. And also, every single piece fits whatever part of the movie that it's in and the tone that the story is trying to get across perfectly. The funny thing is that James Horner actually struggled a lot with creating this score. Him and James Cameron had a lot of creative differences about what the music should actually sound like. James Cameron was looking for a very sort of traditional sounding musical score, while James Horner insisted that they try combining a bunch of different musical styles from across the globe to get a sort of alien sounding music. And I think that what we got was somewhere in the middle. We definitely got a very traditional orchestral makeup instrumentation-wise, but the way James Horner implemented electronic-sounding instruments and very uncommon chord progressions led to a very unique-sounding style. I know that some people are not big fans of the electric-sounding instruments, but I actually think that it fits the movie very well, and when combined with classical orchestral instruments led to a sort of alien sound. Additionally, in every great score, there's always a very iconic musical motif, which for anybody who doesn't know what that means, it's basically just a musical idea. For example, here are some iconic musical motifs from James Horner's music. What makes Avatar's musical motif so unique and iconic is James Horner quite literally breaks the normal rules of music theory. I'll explain what I mean. In this Avatar motif, it starts out on a 6th chord and then transitions into a 5 chord. Now a 6 chord to a 5 chord is definitely possible, but it's not very common, so this already makes the motif interesting. But it's what happens next which gives this progression this iconic Avatar sound. So after a 5 chord, the rules of chord progression say that we should either go to a 1 chord or a 4 chord. A 5 to a 1 chord is very common in Mozart's music, for example, where he goes between the two of them all the time. A good example of a 5 to a 4 chord is in James Horner's iconic motif from Titanic. But instead of going to a 1 or a 4, James Horner goes to a 2 chord, which breaks the rules of standard chord progression. And this does not sound very natural to our ears at all, which makes it sound sort of alien, which is what James most certainly was going for. After the 2 chord, it returns back to the 6 chord, thus completing the motif. And the final result sounds something like this. Let's go! And you can hear this progression everywhere throughout the film in different keys, speeds, and time signatures. Thank you. for some reason it just works, and this in short is what makes the Avatar score so good. If you're looking for a more in-depth explanation of what I just described, Charles Cornell has a very good video where he goes super in-depth about the music theory of it all and really explains how it all works. So if you're interested, definitely go check out that video. So now this brings me along to the score for The Way of Water. Now for this go-around, they weren't able to bring back James Horner because he tragically died in a plane crash in 2015. So for this one, they brought in Simon Franklin, who I actually believe helped James Horner in writing the first movie, so it actually made a lot of sense that they'd bring him in. So I've listened to The Way of Water score a couple times by itself on Spotify, and I've come to the conclusion that it's quite good. However, it's not the masterpiece that the first one was. So since this is a sequel, this score features returning themes from the first Avatar as well as brand new ones. I couldn't give you a percent of how much of the score is new and how much is old, but if I had to guess, it's probably around the 50-50 mark. But the reason that I say I don't think that this score is as good as the first one is because I think that for the most part, the best parts about this score aren't the new pieces, it's the old ones. And also, when the old themes are used throughout the film, I don't think that they were placed as well as they were in the first one. In the first Avatar, every single theme was for a certain scene, and it fit that scene so perfectly. However, in The Way of Water, I kind of felt like all the old themes were kind of just thrown in different parts of the film. It didn't always 100% fit the scenes that they were in. As far as the new music, did I think that it was bad? Absolutely not. On the contrary, I actually think that it was quite good. But even though that music is objectively very well written, I just don't think that it quite possessed the iconic qualities that are gonna make it stand the test of time. This film does have a noticeable musical motif, but I feel as if it was a little underused. If you weren't able to pick out or can't remember what the motif sounded like, I'm quite simply gonna call it the Mai Awa motif, because we first hear it when Neytiri is singing the song chords in the first scene. Its most powerful and emotional version comes in the section where Jake and his family leave home for the unknown. I think that this was a very good motif that Simon Franklin wrote, and was a very emotional piece of music when used at its best. But as I stated before, I do feel like it was a little underused, and I would have liked to see Simon incorporate his motif to the degree that James incorporated his in his work. Another small detail that I like is how the Neytiri singing version effectively opens and pretty much closes the film. I thought it was very poetic and quite clever on Simon Franklin's part to write it that way. Looking ahead, I'm assuming that Franklin will be composing Avatar 3 as well. So if there's one thing that I hope that he improves on, is I want to see him maybe do a little bit better of a job blending the old and the new. At times, it felt a little bit like Franklin's music and Horner's music were almost battling against each other. It would be very interesting to see Franklin sort of combine his music with James Horner's music in each individual piece. I feel like this would give the sense that the music was evolving over the course of the films, rather than just putting the new versus the old up against one another. But that's just a small nitpick and wasn't the biggest issue in the world. In conclusion, although I think it was a little bit of a downgrade, I'm still very satisfied with the final product that Simon Franklin gave us. And with that, in my estimation, all the major topics surrounding Avatar The Way of Water have been covered. There are certainly a number of smaller topics which I could give subsections to, but you could honestly talk about this movie all day if you wanted, and I think that this is a natural place for me to conclude this series. While Avatar The Way of Water certainly isn't a masterpiece of filmmaking, I still highly respect and greatly admire the amount of artistry that went into making this project, and I'm very excited to see what James Cameron brings next for Avatar 3, which will hit theaters in about a year and a half. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you'll be notified when I post my next video. But anyways, that's all I got for today, guys. I'll see you next time.